basically, when you talk about the personality, immediately we call the two important personality types, introvert and extrovert. That things only I'm focusing very fastly. Just I'm showing the person's photo. He said, call you. So this is a small bibliography of him. They call Gustav Jung or Jung in 26 July 1875. He was died in the 6th zone 1961. He's a Swiss, basically he's from Switzerland, and citizens, nationality, everything Swiss only. His field is psychiatry, psychology and psychotherapy, analytical psychology. So these are the contributions made by him. And alma mater is nothing but he's the alumni of the University of Basel. This is a small bibliography about the call you. Just I'm moving to the theory which he focus. This image, if I make it some kind of paragraph, for reading the paragraph takes much time, but that small images, you can understand the exact difference between the two important characteristics of the people. One is called extrovert, other one is introvert. That's why even some kind of advanced technology, there is an education technology proverb, a single image is talking about 1,000 words. So in this image, you can understand what is extrovert, what is introvert. Introvert, they're thinking about themselves only. They don't have open-mindedness as well. And they have the very close few friends only. Yeah, so Abdul Rauf, you can go. Okay, you can go for prayer. So those who want to go,
thank you, sir.
Leave the meeting. Okay, please.
Thank you, sir.
Okay, so within 15 minutes, I can finish it. Okay. So in the case of extrovert, the peoples are open-mind people, and they are accepting the criticism by others also. And apparently, they're thinking about others also. So they have the extrovert have the tendency to be outgoing, very friendliness and talkative and social nature. These are the characteristics that people are having. And apparently, they are very generous. They are very sportive and very courageous too. So these are the good characteristics of the extrovert. And these two images, we can easily to find out who is the introvert and extrovert. Same person only. But sometimes the face reactions also react the person's personality. That's why the Gannons made that kind of things. Sinan Mohammed, kindly leave the meeting. No issue. So those who have any work, you can leave the meeting. Okay. Because I'm going to share the video after my presentation also. Through our Google Classroom, you can get into. And one more assignment only, very small assignment. The assignment, you have to post some of the face reactions of the child. It may be your own child or any other child. Okay. Then make it who is sanguine, who is phlegmatic. You can type the characteristics of the people. You can brief it the images which you capture in your mobile phone. It will be captured by your only. You don't be download from any of the web sources and all. You should take images of any child which belongs to your neighbors or your own child. It's not at all issue. Take some of the good face reactions of the children and post it into our Google Classroom. I'm going to make it some kind of assignment and link. They're here to post. And suppose if you are adding one images of the face reaction of the happy or face reaction, you have to keep typing down the characteristics of the people. Okay, based on the theory suggested by the Gannon. So kindly note it. You have to be upload the things within 1 week. I can make the link after I inform you to the Telegram group. After that, you have to be uploaded. So only the images you have to take by your own mobile camera. You can use any camera. So like I'm going to check your photographic skills also. Whether you have some kind of photographic aesthetic skills and all. So you can take any photos. So maximum 2 or 3 photos is enough. Okay. It represents any kind of facial reactions. But when you uploading any images, you have to give the some kind of interpretations based on this, the temperament based on the characteristics suggested by the Gannon. That's it.
Sir, facial reaction for whom? Children or adults?
That you can take adult also, no problem. So up to the 10 years children, you can take any photo, even the small child. Okay. This is up to you only. Okay. Even you can take your own photo, that is also not for me, that's not an issue for you. You can take your own photo of your different facial reactions. and keep and post it into the our KG classroom. Okay, there is no worry about this thing. You can this is a freedom for all of you. Apparently, I'm going to check your photo graphic skills also. Okay, but for that I'm not giving much. Only for the assignment purpose I'm asking. So just we can see how many people having the good aesthetic sense to take a photo, because this part of our life here after the 21st century. The photography is a part of our culture. That's why I'm giving this kind of small task. Yes. Normally, I won't give the assignment task based on the writing based. So, some kind of experiment based or some kind of skill based on the my assignment task. I am always assigning. That's why this is skill based on assignment task. See this case of this particular images, the left side images, the facial reactions for introvert. But in the case of the Galen theory, so like sad, so it means a melancholic, the left side. The right side is a sanguine, it's nothing but a extrovert in the case of the polio. And see the different facial reactions are there. That's why, but this kind of facial reactions from this we cannot come for any conclusion in the current scenario. Sometimes our predictions of the old theory of the person's personality based on the facial reaction, it not be apt now. Small comparison, how the cops, okay, how the two things should be differ from the extrovert and introvert. The extrovert, these things, cock-a-doodle-do, she may make it some sound in the morning. But in the case of the introvert, they are making some kind of digital footprint only in the internet world. So this is where these two things should be differ. So how the extrovert is doing, how the introvert is doing. And this image also is talking about the introvert. So always thinking by themselves only the introvert. And they are very narrow thinkers. And they have the good imagination. That also we have to appreciate them. The introvert people having good imagination because they're thinking about themselves, and because they don't have time to think about others. No? That's why they always have some kind of dreaming sense they have. But in the case of the extrovert, they're thinking about others. They are very healthy tendency and all. So why I put this center you? So we have to do some kind of analysis, self-analysis, whether you are introvert or extrovert, that you have to find from your head. And small comparison, how the introvert cat is sleeping, how the extrovert cat is sleeping. See, in this case, extrovert, introvert, the sleeping characteristics. So the extroverts, they are widening the leg and hand and all. But the introverts, even the sleeping also, they are very, very narrow. They're very narrow. So this also, there is a difference between the introvert and extrovert. The introvert, I like to think things through before speaking or acting. So the introvert, no, you will not get the much words from them. If you're asking any questions, they think much. Then finally, they are thinking whether they want to share or not. For the thinking also, it takes much time, whether they want to speak or not. That so for this also taking much time to take a decision from the head. I don't like a small talk. So, and I communicate better in writing than a person, because the introvert peoples are they have a small kind of fear to talk the other people's on top. But the extrovert, they are not worried. They are very talkative. They are speak unwanted things also sometimes. So over talkative, the peoples know. They like to speak to others. That's a characteristic for them. I don't like the sudden changes. The introvert don't like the sudden changes. I like to spend time alone. So they always get energy. The introverts are get energy when they're sitting alone only. But the extroverts, they get energy when they sit with others. So there's a two difference felt are there. And this image is also, from this you can understand the people's characteristics. This is called extrovert, which is an introvert. See how the people are enjoying, the two different people, how they're enjoying the rain. So the extrovert, they may like the rain and all. They're playing with the rain and all. But the introvert people, they may sit in the homes they don't like to enjoy the nature and all. Sometimes they may have some dream, they may write the some kind of verse and all. But they are very active. They so it was a very active. They come to the ground, they are working and they are enjoying. But in the case of the introvert, they sit simply sitting in the home and they are thinking about the rain only. They are not enjoying much in this. But in the case, introvert, extrovert, while thinking, discussing about the introvert and extrovert, apparently we have to think about the one is called ambivert. Because most of the people not in the introvert and the extrovert, some people are very moderate level personalities. And based on the reaction, so based on the surrounding or based on the environment, they act sometimes introvert or sometimes an extrovert, otherwise sometimes it's neutral one. That people is called as an ambivert. Actually, this term is not coined by the Carl Jung. This term is coined by after the Carl Jung psychologist only. But this term is much meaningful now because we cannot be easy to divide the people into two aspects only, introvert and extrovert. Because most of the people are lies in the ambivert. Ambivert in the sense, they are always in neutral, that kind of people. Just I'm showing. See here, there is a comparison how the extroversion and introversion are preferences. I prefer to study in a group in the case of the extrovert. The introvert people, they study alone only. They have, that's why I already told, no, they will get the energy through when they sit alone only, in the case of the introvert. These are some of the characteristics of the extrovert. And just I'm going to list out the characteristics. Energized by being around other people. Once they are around some people or they sit with others only, they may get some kind of energized activity. Express thoughts and emotions free. So they won't hide the feeling and all. They open. That's why we use the term as a talkative. And tend to think after they talk. So sometimes, no, they won't think about what they do and just speak. So they openly talkative. Sometimes it may be hard to others also. It says issues in the extrovert people. Act and they then reflect. So first they act, then only they reflect and all that kind of things. Often friendly, talkative and easy to know. So these are the extrovert characteristics. Just I'm going to highlight some of the extrovert personality. One is Steve Jobs and Bill Clinton. They are very active and they are very extrovert. But in the case of the other people, they even the Manmohan Singh and all, we cannot predict the person's personality. Sometimes we could not understand his reactions also. So very introvert nature, Manmohan Singh and all. This the two personalities. I hope you know who is the Steve Jobs. He's a founder of Apple. Then Bill Clinton also, you know. These two people may lies in the extrovert characteristics. Then the parallel highlighting the introvert. They energize by being alone. Keep thoughts and emotions provide. Like to think before they speak. Observe situation before participation. The direct opposite of the characteristics of the extrovert people. Here I am going to highlight some of the introvert peoples. One is called Bill Gates. So even the Bill Gates is a very good, very famous person. But when you go for any kind of interview, like he may speak very few words only. He's not a talkative. And parallel Charles Darwin. These are the two examples of the introvert. But why I'm highlighting the ambivert is a term, no? Because there are only few people who are pure introvert, who are pure extroverts. So others people may lie on the ambivert only. Because now we have to do some kind of research in the ambivert field. Ambivert in this sense, they're listener and talker and good sense to trust, need social and alone time. So sometimes they are social, sometimes they are alone. But the ratio of the introvert and extrovert may be different. See, I'm going to show an image. There is a ratio may change in the levels of the introvert and extrovert. Some people, they're not 100% introvert, some people they're not going 100% extrovert. There is a, some sense of with 50% of introvert functionings they have. Sometimes they withdraw their stance, sometimes they are meeting with the people and all. Sometimes the ambivert may dominate in the sense they have only the 25 introvert functions only. But the extroverts dominating, they may reach 100% extrovert. Otherwise, they reach moderate levels of extrovert. If they come with 25% of extrovert functioning, So it means that they are very near to the ambivert characteristics. So these are the ambivert personality continuum scale. From this we can easily to measure the people's personality. But the ambivert is the term is not coined by the Carl Jung. Why I'm focusing this sense, we may know the two terms only, introvert, extrovert, but we have to understand the meaning of ambivert. That's why I'm focusing here. But according to this Carl Jung, he highlighted only the two terms only, introvert and extrovert. These are the characteristics of the people, and this was a classification. That's why it's called commonly the type kit. Because the classification based on the character, he divided the people's personality into one is called introvert, other one is called extrovert. These are the extrovert characteristics: active, haughty, variety, outer world, expressive, teachers, the things, sociable. The total opposites, they have the introvert, reflective, quiet, focused, inner world, measured, think, then speak, solitude. And some of the skills I'm focusing here: memory, planning, problem solving, motor controlling, self-regulation. These are the skills the introvert people they may get. The extrovert having this much of skills like that. Processing a new information, applying new knowledge quickly, effective, talking more abstractly, and risk-taking. These are the skills those are having the introvert personality and extrovert personalities. The same thing is listed here. So in what way the introvert and extrovert should be different? Just I'm going to be conclude for my presentation. Yes. So I hope my screen is visible to all of you. So within 5 minutes, C.G. Dank or Carl Jung has classified the personality on the basis of the sociability character as introvert and extrovert. Introvert are described as people who share characteristics such as shyness, social withdrawal, and tendency to talk less. Because of these characteristics, these people appear to be self-centered, unable to adjust easily in social situations. They are not easily suggestible. They are future-oriented, very sensible, and rigid in ideas, the introvert. But in the extroverts, they're totally opposed from the introvert people, and they share the tendency to be outgoing, friendly, talkative, and social in nature. They prefer social contacts, generous, sportive, and courageous. So these are the characteristics for the extroverts. So hopefully now we are understanding the difference between the introvert, extrovert, fairly can understand who is an ambivert. Hopefully most of the people like us, we may lies in the ambivert nature only. So thank you all. If you have any doubts, you can ask me now.